That's a good fish.
Toyota presents Fish TV in high definition.
Brought to you by Mercury, Cabela's, world's foremost outfitter. Rapala, crafted from experience.
With your hosts, Leo Stakos, Ron James, and Jeff Chisholm.
Oh, there we go. Oh, oh, just hammered it.
Oh, beautiful.
That is a nice fish right there.
You know what the funny thing is?
I just let that bait sit there, and he came up and hammered it. Let's see if anybody's with him.
It's in the paws, eh?
This is a nice fish, bud.
Yeah, it is. You want to reach out and grab it for you?
I'm thinking we maybe should grab the netter.
Sure.
Oh, man. That's a nice fish. Is a dark fish.
Nice jump.
Oh, man. Oh, beautiful. That's the way to start us off right there.
Very nice. Small mouth.
I got to tell you guys, and we got the privilege today of having not only our title sponsor, but the president of Rapala, Dave Neal. Thanks for coming on the show with us today, bud. We're going to have a fantastic time.
Hey, I'm looking forward to it. We've got a great start here.
Isn't that a beauty, eh? I'll tell you what, I told you, you're in for a real treat in this lake. Once you find them, there's pods of fish around here. Hi, and welcome to the show. I'm Leo Stakos.
I'm Jeff Chisholm.
Nice, dark, chunky fish. Beautiful. What do you say we put this guy in the live book and get some pictures of him?
All right. Jeff?
Okay, so I will tell you one thing, Jeff, we got to slow down our twitches. Yeah. That was just sitting there, and then he went and smashed it. Shad-a-rap shad, catches them all. We like throwing them on spinning for that reason.
So do I, and they're so light, too.
Yeah, and also the control, right? Because the bait caster winds in so much.
Yeah.
It pulls the bait instead of works the bait. Like, I always keep a little bit of slack line like this. See how my line's slack?
Yeah.
Because then the first twitch, it gives it a twitch off it.
It completes the turn on the slack.
It's a little more responsive for sure.
Oh, nice fish.
Good one.
Right on that shoal.
There we go.
Ooh, it's a good one.
Yeah, that's a good fish.
Anybody with them?
Not yet. I love they can't get out of the water. Yeah.
You need the nut butter, you okay?
Too fat to get out of the water. Is it just me, or is that a largemouth?
I thought it was a largemouth.
Yeah, it is.
So then you can reach down and grab that guy.
Here we are, thinking we're gonna catch a smallmouth.
Well, we got a largie.
Beautiful.
Shad-a-rap shad, catches them all.
It's been a great bait for us this year.
And didn't you say when you pre-fished this spot, Jeff, you had a big largemouth come up?
I did.
And eat your drop shot.
It did.
And now we go and get a largemouth. That's a beauty fish right there.
Yeah, it is. Love it. Gorgeous. Let him go. Thank you very much.
Now, what are the largemouth doing in a spot like this? That's what I want to know.
They like to eat. And there's probably some food around. You just caught a perch.
Yeah, that's true. In fact, the perch were the almost exact same size as that shad-a-rap shad there, yep. And the same color. So you're using the right color bait, that's for sure.
We saw those two loons in there, so I'm sure they were working on a little bit of bait fish.
Oh, for sure. It's always a good sign when you go where other people are eating.
That's right.
I always cue it up as going to a buffet. If the buffet is empty, it's not a good place to go. So if you see the loons, we're in the right spot.
You're in the right spot. Well, I think the jerk baits are a good choice right now. We can cover lots of water and find out where they are.
Why are they not smashing this chug bug?
Yeah. Here, I'll grab the net for you. I'm coming right up on that net down area.
Yeah.
But you called that too.
You called it from a mile away. That neck down looks good.
Funnel the bait, funnel the fish.
Yeah, with the wind the way it is. There's not too much we can do, but.
And look how shallow he was sitting in.
Yeah, maybe 3-4 feet of water at the most. Put him back.
Nice work.
There you go.
This is why it's a good feeding area. Did you get a rock there?
Yep.
There we go.
Oh,
come on.
Fish. Oh, yeah. There you go. Oh, he's off.
He's off.
Oh, yeah. Nice bite. That's a netter there, buddy. Hold her there for a second. We'll get the net. Nice fish, buddy.
Beautiful.
Oh, yeah.
That is beautiful. Yeah, it's amazing. You know, we're finding them all in deep water on the Panoptix.
Yeah, I was just, you know, sort of twitching that shadow wrap real lately across that shallow water. And
so you think it's the way you were twitching it then?
I slowed down the retrieve a little bit
from
this morning, and yeah.
Well, there you go.
That might have triggered it, so that's a good fish.
Beautiful.
Look at the colors on it. It's dark, too.
Should we put him in the live well for a picture later?
That'd be great. Yeah. Here, you want to get it for you?
Nice, buddy. Now let me see you do that again with that purple.
That's right. It was the purple, wasn't it? We just switched up from the olive and bang, get right back at it.
It's a beast.
On the purple again.
Oh, nice one. Yeah.
Oh, another beauty on that shadow wrap.
Yeah, there you go, man.
Okay, so I stand corrected, folks. I was making fun of Dave for using a purple shadow wrap. What do you got on? You got the deep shad wrap.
We got the deep shadow wrap.
The bad news is Jeff and I casted there first, and neither one of us got the fish.
I like to come through and clean up a little bit. We got a few more purple.
Nice fish.
You know what? I think you should put that one in the live well too, bud. We can get a free shot of it.
Might as well.
We can do that. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. A fish for Leo to hold.
But actually, I think, you know, the color is important, and that was why I switched to the purple. The chartreuse was starting to look a little bright up in that bright, high sun in this clear water.
You did mention that in the water, it was almost invisible.
Right.
And you think that going with a lower profile actually helped. And so far, guess what? It is helping.
Seems to work. Yep.
Good
stuff.
The problem we're up against is there's not a lot of fish. In areas like this, we're fishing structure. We're picking off the odd fish that's sitting on a rock or a boulder or a stump or a dark spot.
I think it's just about covering water on a day like today.
For sure. That's why the baits we're using are great. But you know what? This is bothering me. This is the perfect time to bring out the chug. Hey, you're going to go home and you're going to tell your kids. So I was fishing with Leo Stackles, and he pulled out this chug bug, and he caught a 9-pounder.
Pull out the bug.
Look at this, man. Are you kidding me? First cast. Look at these boulders. No wonder you GPS this spot. Oh!
That's a good one.
He's staying down, man.
Well, it sounded like a good fish. I didn't get a good look at it, but it sure sounded like it. Oh, you got him in the back.
Oh, it's a tank.
It's a thick one.
Oh, it's a good fish.
I love this clear water.
Wow.
Chug bug in the middle of the day.
Yeah. Beautiful. Oh, we use chug bugs all day long. We love them.
Yeah.
Calm water, even a little wind.
Look at this.
They always work.
That is beautiful. Look at that. Oh, yeah.
Nice one.
He is a tank.
Beautiful fish.
He's digging, man. He does not want to come up. I'm doing the twirl. Nice, thank you, Jeffrey.
Very nice.
Nice
deal.
Work.
Good work.
Oh yeah, he's a heavy fish. Look at that. Now that is beautiful. Chug bug. We got about 20 feet of water beside us. We got 9 feet of water in boulders, rock, structure, logs. And that guy's eating. Look at that.
What a nice topwater fish.
Isn't that a beautiful fish?
Love that.
What do you think, Jeff? Good.
I think that's a picture fish for
sure. Yeah,
so? That's a good heavy one.
Well, we were just about to leave this area, and I think I can throw a couple more casts.
acrobatic little guy, isn't he?
He came up and sucked it in. I wonder if anybody's with him. Not a giant, but he's fun. Look at him go. Look at him go. I'll tell you what, for a little fish, this guy's like digging away. Oh, he swiped at it. That's why. Look at him. He swiped at it. Let me get this guy up. That's why he was fighting so hard.
Two in a row on the tugboat.
Tell you what, though, they're a lot of fun. There we go. Another beautiful fish. On the top water.
Well, I'm going to have to try another top water.
Uh-oh. You can't show that one. That's not available yet. Actually, yeah. You know what? We got the right guy in the boat to ask. When are these going to be available, Dave?
The Skitter V, that's on the market for 2017.
Perfect.
That's
so
good.
So you'll see it in stores anytime from January, February 2017 and on.
That is fantastic, yep. Because you know what? That's when this show is going to air. And we get the benefit of testing it out.
That's right.
Oh, there goes the purple. Way out, look at that. Oh.
Come on, hit one right there, Leo. It'll look beautiful.
I just did. Didn't you see that? Oh, there he is again. Oh! He hit it twice.
Portions of Fish TV are brought to you by Sylvania Automotive Lighting. Do you want to see better while driving at night?
Got him.
Seriously?
Yep.
And we spotted him
100%. That fish was caught from the sonar. That's not the same fish.
No, that's not the that's same not fish. The same that was fish. A bigger, much bigger fish, but.
But we did mark that fish. The big one has still got away. He's down there though. We'll find him.
Nice fish, bud. He just came right off that rock there. I looked down and I saw a bunch of weeds and rock and I said, you know what?
Oh, nice jump.
Good one.
I love how clear the water is in this lake.
It's beautiful.
You can see them down there so far. It's just gorgeous.
Oh, look at him digging away there. He is fighting like a big boy. Nice.
Little healthy fish here too, aren't they?
Oh, for sure.
Another good one.
Look at that.
Just came up, smashed the bait.
Nice.
Hook just fell right out. That is a beautiful fish right there. We are having a blast today, guys.
This is unbelievable.
Between you putting a clinic on. All right, get this guy back in the water. I think there's more fish in these rock and weeds here.
I would say that's probably a good estimate.
It's time for the Old Milwaukee Tip of the Week.
Hey folks, Leo Stockwell here with your Tip of the Week. I gotta tell you something, we had a fantastic day here fishing with our good friend Dave Neal from Rapala. The fishing was great, the smallmouth was great, the company was even better. But I gotta tell you something, we have to work really hard for these fish. The last time we were on this lake was about 3 years ago, we caught them all along one shoreline. Guess what, we went there today and there was nothing around. That means that we had to go out there and find the fish. We started finding structure fish off of main lake points and drop-offs, and that's where the fish were. So make sure when you go out here fishing, guys, let the fish tell you where to find them, because they will always be correct.
Oh, no, there's another fish with him. Yeah, there's.
I'm going in.
There's one or two there.
Well, the way he hit you, that's why I figured there'd be another one there.
It was a good strike.
Oh, did you get him, Jeff?
Missed him.
No.
He's a smaller one. Still hitting that jerkbait.
Yeah, you got him right off this clump of rocks and weed here.
Yeah, it came right off the point, so he can go back.
Oh, he's on it now.
I don't know how big it is, but...
Well, we're going to find out. Looks pretty good. He's dogging down there.
He's
pretty
dogging
good.
Down, but he might just be hooked in the back. Hard to say. What do we got
I
here?
I think he's a 9-pounder, bud. Oh, nice fish.
There's two more with him. Oh. Two more. There's two more with him.
Oh, yeah.
I'll grab my drop shot rod there.
All right.
You want to grab my drop shot rod there?
Now this one hit the shadow wrap, shad. We got two more here, so the other guys are going to drop down, see if they can catch them. Hey, this one's hooked pretty good, so I might as well hold on to him and he'll keep those other fish around. What happens with smallmouth is they spit up their bait, anything in their stomachs a lot of the time. The other ones know that, so they're looking for the easy meal.
All right, we'll bring this guy in.
Beautiful.
That's why he hit it so hard, because there was two other ones with
it. Yep. Competition.
That's like us fishing.
Yeah.
So what kind of retrieve were you using there?
That was just he actually hit that on the paws.
Yeah.
And that's the nice thing about this bait. It's on the paws, it's got a slow lift to it. I know, like when we're ice fishing in that, often just lifting that bait a little bit, when you got a fish on the screen, that rise triggers the bite. And this bait right here, the shadow wrap shad, jerk bait on the paws, instead of just suspending, it's got that slow lift. Sometimes that'll do the trick, like it did right here. Let that guy go.
Nice work.
Awesome.
Right off that log.
Nice fish.
Beautiful.
Again, he didn't slam it though. Just on that one hook, look at it.
You get him for you?
Yeah, I'm just gonna lift her up like this. Make life easy. And there we go. Beautiful.
Very nice.
I saw a log sticking out of the water
there. There's one.
I catch it on the outside, and you got one as well. But you got his baby brother.
Yeah, little guy.
Again, he didn't swipe at it. He just swiped
right in the cheek.
Get this guy back in the water. And get ourselves another one.
Reel them in with the right tools from the Toyota Tackle Box.
Hey guys, let's take a minute of the action and show you exactly what we're using today. We chose to use Wrapless Concept rods and Concept spinning reels today. We're using the 6'6" medium fast action rod, and it does a great job of fighting these smallmouth. We're using Suffix 832 braided line on those and Suffix fluorocarbon leader. And it's great line to get the job done as well. We caught a lot of fish in this clear water on the Storm Chug Bud. Tried, tested, and true bait catches a lot of fish. But what was the real winner?
You know, I think the real winner was really this shadow wrap minnow in the size 11 in the deep version. We were really getting down to those fish. They were pretty finicky. They weren't really chasing it down, so we had to finesse them a little bit and twitch it down to that 8 to 10 foot range, and this seemed to get the job done.
And so the next time you're fishing smallmouth, don't forget your Storm Chug Bugs and your Wrapless Shadow Wrap minnows. Let's get back to that Fish TV action.
Nice, he came up and hit that thing twice. I'll bet you there's another one there, bud.
You think so?
You know what? The first one
just
came flying this way.
The way he approached it, eh?
Yep, that guy came and hit it twice. Not a big fish, but I think there was two or three of them around. That was classic Chug Bug right there.
That's a great topwater fish.
I gotta tell you something, the Chug Bug is probably the most underrated bait in the Rapala lineup. This thing consistently catches big largemouth, big smallmouth. I've even caught a walleye on it, believe it or not. There we go, thank you. Look at that, right down. You think you wanted that Chug Bug?
I think he wanted it.
Let this guy go back in the water quickly, recoup. Beautiful.
Good work, Leo.
Right on the edge. What we're doing right now is we got 26 feet of water. We've got a shallow rocked flat coming off a point with about 30, 40 feet of water around it. Perfect location to throw a Chug Bug for these fish that are moving up to eat crayfish, to go after any bait fish that are in the area. So we're gonna keep working this point all the way down. There's some sand deposits as we go down there. I think it's gonna be a good spot. It's gonna work out. This looks like a pretty good spot here, guys.
Yeah,
coming
I'd
off
say
that
so.
Point, there was actually 100 feet of water off the point of that island. 100 feet, an
nice
ideal
taper.
Laker spot, but it's also an ideal smallmouth spot for these fish to come in here and feed. I'm not in my line.
Looks like lots of boulders, and maybe you'll get one on a Chug Bug.
There's gotta be a fish here, guys. Like giant boulders, deep water beside it, logs.
catch him, will you?
I'm trying. Oh, there you go.
There we go.
Oh, he lost it. Oh, Dave.
How'd that one feel?
That was a giant. Probably at least 9 pounds.
He hit it like a 9-pounder.
Ah, and the way he jolted you, he looked like he did. Right on that break, eh? 20 feet of water. Like, there's no reason for them not to be here. Like, it's just, there's too much good structure. 100 feet of water out in front. If I was a smallmouth, this is where I would hang out.
Did you cut the hooks off of his bait yet?
No. Yeah, we're gonna start calling him the Purple King. Maybe we'll call him Prince. That's what we should call him. Prince Neil. Feeling of us getting fish here, Jeff, may have been gas or something.
Fish.
Oh, nice. Good one. Oh, the tank. Take him. Bring him in slow. He's a tank, man. Touching the net. Okay. He's a tank. Okay, let me just get us off these rocks here for a second, Dave. Oh.
Right off that point on that sand. Yeah. I'm not ready yet.
You were on fire, man.
Oh, look at the size of this guy.
That bait has been hot for you.
Beauty fish,
oh,
man.
Oh, nice.
I'll tell you what.
Can I say one thing?
You can say one thing.
I love it when you don't have to change a lure all day long. Remember when I switched to the purple?
You switched to the purple and you kept it all day long. I gotta tell you guys, we've had a fantastic day here. I really wanna say a special thank you to Dave. Came all the way down here from Rapla to enjoy a day of fishing with us. Thank you so much, Brad. I hope you had a lot of fun with us today.
Hey, it's been a great day. A lot of laughs and some great fish.
A lot of laughs. You know what? There's gonna be a lot more laughs on Fish TV. Until next week, I'm Leo Stackles.
I'm Jeff Chisholm.
We'll see you next time on Fish TV.
Bye-bye.
Nice fish, bud. Camera.
Nice one.
All right.
That's great.
I say we release that bad boy and get ourselves another one, bud.
That's awesome.
Good job.
Fish TV has been brought to you by Old Milwaukee. It doesn't get any better than this. Lund, the ultimate fishing experience. And your Ontario Toyota dealers. Real people, great cars.